Welcome back. 7:38 now. Here's the latest in job-stealing robots. Drone Seed is a startup based out of Seattle that is changing the way we plant trees. So currently, planting trees is still a manual labor job, but these specially designed drones can map out sections of forest destroyed by wildfires and actually launch the seeds needed for reforestation. Take a look.
A good tree planter can replant somewhere between 800 trees a day, which is about 2 acres. One person with 15 drones could do the equivalent of 360 manual labor hours of tree planting or spraying in a day.
We use a seed, so there's no nursery, there's no need for a refrigerated supply chain, and it's not an issue for us to put 80 to 200 different species into the hopper and then spray them all over the ground.
It is a step function. It's a disruptive technology. We are already in beta as far as a software platform that allows one operator to manage 15 drones simultaneously. And then that takes us
pretty amazing. So you may not have noticed because it was going so fast, but those seeds are actually being launched into the ground at 238 miles per hour.
Oh my gosh.
Isn't that incredible? So the drones can plant up to 800 seeds per day, which obviously means we get a lot more trees in a lot less time.
Mm-hmm.
What would that do to an animal?
I'm sorry, I shouldn't say
that.
That's a good thought.
Yeah.
I was going to say a human, but I didn't want to be morbid. But like, that's so fast. That's,
hopefully they are intelligent enough and they're controlled
to be able to
by
see.
Somebody. Yeah, yeah, to be able to detect if there is a living creature.
Okay.
Because that would kind of defeat the purpose if we're reforesting, but we're also not taking into account that there is wildlife.
But drones are so loud, it might scare away them.
That's
maybe
true.
So good point. Some are loud, some are pretty quiet. I don't know.
The sneaky,
you're right, though.
Quieter
maybe.
Drones.
Maybe. I would hope, considering how intelligent these people are,
that's
I would hope
true.
They would take that into consideration.
So true. So crazy. A little boy is winning hearts in the skies. Check out what he did on a flight from Kansas City to North Carolina.
He wants to fist pump you.
Let's do it.
You notice we have the machine closed.
Keep the aircraft a little bit cooler.
Blow it up.
Oh.
Yeah, he was given fist bumps. His mother, a Casey native, posted this video on Instagram of the two-year-old fist bumping people on a Southwest flight. She said, quote, "My son is on the campaign trail in the hopes of becoming the next Southwest ambassador."
We need to find that little boy. Is he from Kansas City?
Said Casey native, so yeah.
I mean, yeah. We've
He's
find
probably
him
in,
talk
where,
to
where
him.
Is he flying to? North Carolina right now, but maybe on his way back.
Yeah.
Come in and, yeah,
find
fist
him.
Bump us.
Want to talk
find
to
out,
him.
Find out what inspired
the
fist bump.
I know, the
right?
boy yeah, and the reaction.
Like
all right. A snake believed to be a carpet python managed to find its way into the offices of an Australian news channel.
Nope.
Yeah, look at that.
Nope.
A cameraman first spotted the reptile curled up on the desk. The station's program manager has handled snakes before on her property and probably on her job.
Wow.
She used a coat hanger and a bag to actually capture the snake with a sales executive helping her. I think the executive's kind of standing back. That's a brave woman.
I guess in Australia.
Mercy.
She was so calm, it looked like it.
She's definitely done this before.
No, I'm going to go back downstairs and check my desk and just make sure that there's no...
Are they
just
definitely venomous? That's what I want to know. Snakes don't bother me as long as they're not venomous, but if I don't know,
okay.
I'm not going to touch them.
Okay. I don't know.
A carpet python.
So
I'll have to
step back.
I feel like if you live in Australia, though, you're also just kind of well-versed in this no matter what.
Okay.
Australia is like some of those deadly species. That's why I'm like, of course
exactly.
It happens in Australia.
You learn to walk, eat, and handle poisonous creatures.
There you go.
My gosh. Nope. I would have been out of there in like 5 seconds.
No kidding.
No, 1 second.
No kidding. Many in Central Florida have a lot of cleanup to do today. Take a look at the flooding Tropical Storm Emily caused. This video is from the city of Lakeland. Several homes there were flooded and area roads have been closed because of rising water. Emily was downgraded to a depression last night, but meteorologists expect it to gain strength and be reclassified as a tropical storm as it moves away from Florida as it enters the Gulf Stream there in the Atlantic Ocean.
Got to worry about those people walking through that water. It's gotta be contaminated, and then their homes are just
and you don't know what's under there either. That's one of the big things about flooding is you're taking a lot of things that shouldn't be in the water and now putting them under the water, even like branches or pieces of metal.
It is dangerous,
And talk about snakes on the last story. I bet there are a lot of interesting animals in that water too from the ocean.
We did learn that those are not venomous. Yes, our producer just told me
the carpet
are not venomous. I don't care.
They're huge.
Carpet python.
No.
Is there there a Florida
I would get out of there.
Just got to be able to identify them. So she's a smart lady.
That's
she
true.
Knew. She and she
knew.
Was like, I can handle this. I got
to And
hanger.
Took it out safely, like to a better place for them.
Big smart bummer to her,
just for her.
Yeah, nope. we need to hire her if something were like that to happen. But all morning long, we've been watching some fog, and Jade's been keeping her eye out on the roadways and looking much better out there on our maps. Just down to 3 miles in Lee Summit, we'll look at some sky cameras across the area and just see when this will completely clear coming up.
Next, last man standing. It's the land of the free and the home of the Baxters.
Please just do this, okay? Because you put up the stupid poll weeks ago, and so far it's just been a magnet for every moron with a tongue.